Hi everybody, this is Alice Bejeweled Hedgehog, and I have a makeup haul video. I know this is a very funny video coming from someone who does not wear much makeup, but you know, in the spring, I get the urge to do more things than I normally have the urge to do in the winter. And, you know, by the time the summer comes around, it's so hot and humid that you put makeup on, and, you know, by the time you walk to the car, it's kind of all washed off. So I tend to actually, when I play around with makeup and do put it on, it tends to be a spring and fall thing. So, as you can see, lipstick. I did a makeup haul. I ordered makeup from Veggie Beauty. I saw her describing her newest line of cosmetics, Frankly Scarlet, on Gifted Hands, and I was very impressed. Her line is Pumpkin and Poppy. I am not affiliated with her. I'm not, you know, getting, this is not advertising. This is just kind of under the category, I guess, of cool stuff that Alice likes, and Alice happens to like Pumpkin and Poppy. So basically, the thing that I got from her new line, Frankly Scarlet, is this eyeshadow. It's called Melanie, and I have a feeling that with my lighting and my camera, you're not going to be able to see the colors all that well, but this is a silver pinky beige color, which is great because if you are lazy like me and you have an occasion where you feel like you should wear some makeup but you don't want to take a lot of time, having the kind of glittery and sort of iridescent variants in the shades means if you don't feel like messing with more than one color, you can just put one swipe of this on. And it has a depth of color, so you can kind of get away with, you know, just kind of one swipe from the brow to your lash line and not have to do the three-color thing. Now, this morning I did a two-color thing on my eyes because I felt like playing with makeup. But trust me, on ordinary mornings, no. So anyway, I got this. And her prices are reasonable. I don't know if I should say prices. I mean, I don't know if that makes it, you know, like advertising. I have no idea what YouTube guidelines are. But anyway, I'll just tell you anyhow. Her prices are $4.75, and you get a pretty reasonably sized little container. Now, I go for neutrals because being me, I don't go out much at night. I don't go places where the striking dramatic colors, you know, would really be appropriate. I mean, in my younger days, I liked Urban Decay, for instance. You know, they're iridescent blues, greeny colors. But anyway, so much for that. I also got another color called Courtier, and well, you're not seeing this at all. Actually, back here you see it a little better. It's like a peachy goldy color. I think this would be best used as a highlighter color, but actually you could get away with doing this as just an all-over if you want a few swipes just to make you look a little more finished. Let's see. Notre Dame, when you get to this color, it is a deeper kind of browny taupe color. And this is a great color if you are going to do a little bit of the actual shadowing. Because pretty much, I mean, it would, in my opinion, it would go with anything, and you really can't see it here, but, let's see, did I show you Champagne? Yes, I did. And then the one that I have on today I have on Melanie, and this one, Cherry Wood. And Cherry Wood is a dark reddish brown, and it's a very, very pretty color. I think it goes well with brown eyes. Let me show you my eyeshadow. See if you can see it at all. I'll move closer and then further back, you know, to see what the camera is doing. A natural daylight makes things look bright, but for some reason here and with my particular camera, it tends to wash things out. But anyway, you saw some eyeshadow. And I like it because they all have a touch of iridescence. They're all going to show up under my glasses. I love glasses because they kind of hide the fact most of the time that I'm not wearing eye makeup. I mean, people notice, you know, the cool shape, the dark frames, and these are little rhinestone-y things here. So frequently, if I have glasses and I put on a touch of colored lipstick, you just kind of see something fancy going on up here and something fancy going on down here, and you don't really notice I'm not wearing any makeup. But today, since I am wearing makeup, I will tell you about it. This is also from her Frankly Scarlet collection, and it is called, let me take a quick look, it is called, Frankly Scarlet Lip Gloss, and she describes it as warm coral red orange with pink undertones, which I think pretty much sums it up very nicely. You know, the colors seem truer when I get a little further back here. So it's what I've got on my lips now. It goes on very smoothly. It smells good. It has a great flavor, although I know you're not supposed to eat it. Okay, so that's all the colorful stuff. And then I have a product. This is not from her. This is a sinfully expensive product. This is the first time I've used it, but the concept of it is very good, and I bought another product from her kind of to replace it when this runs out. This brand is NP Set, and it says Calming Pre-Foundation Primer, and at the top it says For Redness. And obviously, since I don't wear foundation that much, what I tend to do is, you know, get out of the shower, put on my words flee. I swear, when I click the Logitech camera icon, it just causes this one long senior moment. But anyway, the stuff you put on your face, the astringent-y stuff, you know, that goes on first thing before you put on your moisturizer, duh, which is the name escapes me. But anyhow, put on that, put on the moisturizer, good to go. And then I go ahead and put a little bit of this on, and it's green. Well, I'm not going to squeeze it out because it costs a small fortune. And if you look at it right out of the tube, you would think that Alice is preparing for the zombie apocalypse by trying to disguise herself as a zombie. But actually, no. As you can see, my face is not green, and I wear this pretty much every day since I got it because it's so quick and easy. Just after the moisturizer, smear a little bit of this on my cheeks and chin and around my nose, and away I go. This stuff, although green, goes over red blotchy skin, and it does not look green. What it tends to do is even out the redness, and I have two things going on. I tend to get some kind of adult acne, even though I'm 50. I shouldn't have this anymore, but it's not, life is not fair, is it? I tend to get some jawline acne, and of course, because my skin is sort of thin, fair, I have clueless what you want to call it, the scars will be red for a little while before they fade out. And I also have a little bit of rosacea, where I get those uneven red blotches on my skin no matter what kind of products I use, and I get it around my nose. So putting a green, just a light layer of green on those areas really does reduce the redness. Drawback, this thing was $29. I bought it when I was at Target waiting for a prescription to be filled. And you know, I've been toying around in my mind for a while because I'd seen this in magazines and things. Not this brand, but this concept of correcting redness with green. And there I was with, you know, at least half an hour to kill. And somehow or the other, I bought this. I'm happy with the product, terribly unhappy about the price. Pumpkin and Poppy, on the other hand, has the very same thing in a powder form, which is nice because I actually tend to prefer powder forms, especially in the summer, since my skin gets oily and I really don't want to have to smear another smeary thing on my face. So it is the same shade of green, which I think must be the universal get rid of redness shade of green. There's a little sifter inside, even though you can't really see it, so you can shake out a little bit and either use a cotton ball or a brush to put it on the red spots. And I have not tried this yet because I actually didn't think of putting on makeup until I'd already, you know, had on my morning stuff, you know, my moisturizer and my other corrector. But she charges for what looks like it's the same amount or possibly even a little more. She charges $10.25. So I am going to try this tomorrow morning, and I will let you know what I think. But, you know, it looks like it's the very same color. It is powder, which is preferable. So I think I have found a wonderful solution to the price problem. Okay, the other thing is I got three samples. Oh, they all look the same. From here. Anyway, I got three samples of foundation from her. And for $2.50, she will send you fairly good-sized baggies. Oops, here's the Pumpkin and Poppy logo. Of three different shades of foundation to try. And I tried her two lightest shades, peach and seashell, and then her medium, which is cashew. And you cannot tell from the camera lighting, so I'm not even going to hold these up. As soon as I looked at them, the seashell was too pink, the creamy peach was way too light, and the cashew looked just right. And I am wearing the cashew. And it just goes perfectly. And it's very simple. You take a little brush, flick it over your face. I take my finger and just dab it over my I have always had dark circles under my eyes. I could sleep for 12 hours and wake up with dark circles under my eyes. And that is a pain in the butt, because when I wear contacts, the glasses tend to cover it. You know, it's not blatant, but my eyes are actually kind of large behind the glasses, shrink them down, and also kind of shrinks down the dark circles. When I wear my contacts and my typical no makeup look, I have these dark circles and this blotchy red skin, and I swear to you, I look like a crack addict, you know, with these huge dark purple circles under my eyes. And I hate that, because I'm not a crack addict, and I'm not sick, and I'm not dying or anything else. So I generally like to put something, if I'm wearing contacts, on those circles, even if I don't wear, oh my goodness, I have lost my words today, even if I'm not wearing foundation. So anyhow, concealer will work. And I saw that Laura, Crochet Zombie, had bought a yellow concealer thing, and I am so curious to see how that works. But anyway, so there you go. Now, the powder corrector, the one thing about having this bright washed out light is you don't see the little scars and flaws on camera that you would see if I were sitting in front of you. The powder foundation, just put over with a brush, does beautiful things for evening out my skin tone. But the little redder scars, it just doesn't quite get rid of. But I mean, I don't care. I have adult acne. There's a limit. I mean, you can buy products that will cover up pretty much anything. But I'm not going to mess with them. So anyway, I really love my cosmetic haul. Oh my gosh, I've made this almost 13 minutes. Just to let you know, she gives you these little cute bags. And she sent a business card. So when I upload this video, Pumpkin and Poppy, I'm going to type in all her information. And while I am here, I am going to show you some jewelry, because this is kind of collaboration jewelry. This jewelry was made by me. I'm going to take this off and put this right up next to here. Oh, the glare issues. Ah, okay, it's a little wooden pendant. There you go, no glare. It's a little wooden square, actually, that my oldest niece painted, the tree and the sheep. Ah, coordination way beyond me. So she made it, and I added a little backing to it to make it a pendant, and then I put it on a necklace, and I kind of mixed copper and silver. There are both copper and silver chains here. I did the beads and then added a copper chain. And then while she was at it, she had some leftover paint. Let's put you down on my arm. And she painted a bead, a plain wooden bead, green for me. Ah, where is it? Ah, okay. So here it is, and you know, I strung it. This is a, by the way, this is a little like white crystal with a black crystal on top, because it good God, where is it? All right, I am not a coordinated person, as you can see. It's a miracle that I do crafts, by the way. I really think it's an absolute miracle, considering I can't show a bracelet, but I thought it looked like a little sheep, and a little sheep, and a little picture thingy. So, It all matches. So anyway, that is my cosmetic haul. It was supposed to be short, but it wasn't. But anyway, thank you, wonderful, wonderful subscribers and viewers. Sorry for the guy subscribers and viewers that this is not a craft video. I will write makeup really big so you don't waste any time watching it. Anyway, have a wonderful Sunday. I'm going to go out and do springy things as soon as I make one more video. Okay, bye.